Did you know when printers go down, the results are an average of 23 minutes of lost productivity? When printers move or change locations, 90% of organizations don't know how many they have. SOTI Connect does all the hard work of auto-discovering printers once they attach to your networks, so you can make more smarter and accurate decisions regarding your printer fleet. Hey, how's it going? My name is Mario. I'm a sales engineering manager here at SOTI, and welcome to a SOTI How-To Series. This episode is the second part of a three-part series where we will show you the following: how to set up and register the MQTT server that will be used to enroll Zebra printers into SOTI Connect. In this video, I will show you how to download and use OpenJDK, set up environment variables, and configure.xmls to run the MQTT server, install Windows services, and register the MQTT server on SOTI Connect. Let's get to it. To be able to enroll Zebra printers, we will need to set up the MQTT server and register it on SOTI Connect. But first, we should review some technical requirements. You will need the following: the Java key store, which is created in the previous videos of this series, Notepad++ or a similar text editor, OpenJDK Hive MQ Community Edition, Hive MQ config.xml template, SOTI Connect server running with the MQTT protocol, and of course, access to the SOTI Connect console. Now that we are all set, let's start configuring. Download the OpenJDK version 11 from the address shown on the screen. Then download the latest available version of Hive MQ Community Edition from its GitHub page. Download the Hive MQ config XML TLS template to run the Hive MQ with TLS settings, which can be provided by your SOTI sales engineer. Next, download the HiveMQ Windows service from hivemq.com to run the HiveMQ as a Windows service. Once we have all these files downloaded, we will be able to extract each of them. Extract the OpenJDK, extract the HiveMQ Community Edition, extract the HiveMQ and Q Windows service. Now that the files under the Windows Service folder move into the extracted MQ Hive folder, then move all the files into the folder, up to this folder, and then add file version as a suffix to the README file for reference. Now you can delete the empty Hive MQ Hive folder. Next, move the extracted files for OpenJDK 7.1 into the Windows Program file/Java. And create the folder if required. Use the search Windows command, find the edit system variables, and update the environment variables like this. Create the Java underscore home under system variables, pointing to the JDK 11 folder and the under system variables slash path. Add reference to the JDK 11 bin folder and move that to the top of the list. Next, for HiveMQ, move both HiveMQ config TLS template and the MQTT certificate Java key store to the HiveMQ conf folder. Rename the original config XML file to conflict-original or something similar just for future reference. Rename the config TLS template to config. We will rename the HiveMQ folder, removing the version number from it, as it has now been added to the README file. That will simplify performing future Hive MQ version upgrades while retaining the existing Windows service that refers to the files in that folder. Move the Hive MQ folder from the downloads to your preferred location. Check the update and the config example, ensuring that the port Java keystore path and the keystore and the private keystore password for the TLS TCP listener are accurate. Run the Hive MQ using the run batch file to confirm that Hive MQ runs correctly. Establishes the TLS and listens on the expected port. For example, here, port 8883, press Ctrl+C and stop HiveMQ. After confirming that HiveMQ is running correctly, we will install the Windows service as administrator. We'll verify that HiveMQ appears on the Windows service and then restart the server. When the server is back up, confirm that the HiveMQ Windows service is running. Now that we have that MQ server running, we will register it on the required MQTT server using the appropriate root certificate in PAM format, as we explained in the previous video. If necessary, the MQTT root certificate is exported from the 8K certificate database in a PAM format, where it was created initially and is securely stored. Finally, log in to SOTI Connect. We can see that under the administration and system management, the MQTT server is registered using the appropriate MQ protocol adapter and PAM certificate. If you click on the notification bubble, you can see that the MQ server is successfully registered on SOTI Connect. And that's it. In just a few minutes, we have learned how to set up and register the MQTT server on SOTI Connect and enabled Zebra and other brand printers to self-report any potential issues before they even become severe, allowing IT to take any necessary proactive actions. Thanks for tuning in. Remember to subscribe to our channel to get the latest updates if you find our content valuable.